Hey guys, in this tutorial I want to show you how you can compress your image assets for your Spark AR Studio project, because you may have encountered the following error message when uploading your filter to your Instagram camera. Effect file is too big, reduce each effect file to 4 MB or less, and also when you click on upload and export, you will see that your effect file is way too big to upload. It's because the filter has to be on 4 MB or less. And yeah, in this video I want to show you how you can compress your image assets in a fast and easy way, because as you can see here, I have some background replacement images here, and they are pretty big in resolution and also have much detail. So yeah, those are pretty big files, and yeah, now let us compress them. For sure I could use the built-in compression here of the Spark AR Studio, but I don't really like it, because when you want to compress your pictures, it slows down the Spark AR Studio pretty much, and it also takes a long time on compressing. So yeah, I don't use the built-in compression method of the Spark AR Studio. So the first and very important step is that you navigate to your effect folder and then go to your textures folder, and here you will see all your pictures or graphics you have imported to your Spark AR Studio project. And as you can see here, these 5 pictures have together 7.4 MB. So how do I compress them? I have found this web service called DynePNG, and here we can compress our pictures pretty much. So just navigate to your textures folder. As I said, it's pretty important to upload the pictures from your textures folders. Why is this important? I will show you in a second. So yeah, just drag and drop it into the web service, then it will upload your files, and here you can already see how much the pictures are compressed. So after the compression is done, just click on download all and it will download a zip folder. Then just navigate to your downloads folders, unzip the downloaded zip folder, and then just open the folder. So here you will find all the compressed pictures, and here you see the important part: the file names haven't changed. So we can just select all the pictures and drag and drop it into the textures folders, because they have the exact same file name, and we get asked if we want to replace all of them, and yes, we want to replace all of them. So now you just have to go back to your Spark AR Studio, and you don't have to re-import your pictures again, because you replaced them in the textures folders. And now when you want to upload and export the filter, wait a minute, we have to save our project. Now when you want to upload and export the project, you will see that the Spark AR Studio already replaced all the files. So yeah, I hope this video helped you in your Spark AR workflow. If yes, give it a thumbs up, and if you're new to this channel, it would be cool if you subscribe to it. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video. Bye.